Welcome to Chemistry with Caroline. In this video, we're going to look at sp2 hybridization in carbon atoms for organic chemistry. So we're going to start off with the energy diagram, looking at what the atomic orbitals look like, and then what happens when hybridization occurs. So the valence atomic orbitals of a carbon atom are in the 2-shell. You have one 2s orbital, 3 degenerate 2p orbitals, degenerate meaning equal in energy. They're all peanuts that are just varying by a 90 degree orientation around an xyz axis. So there are 2 electrons in the 2s orbital and then 2 electrons in the 2p orbital. Those are both singly occupied. It's less energy for them to be singly occupied in equal energy orbitals than to be spin paired. So for sp2 hybridization to occur, it's going to be the combination or mixing of 1s orbital and then 2p orbitals. So I'm going to use 3 atomic orbitals. And if I use 3 atomic orbitals, then the result will be that 3 hybrid orbitals are formed. Okay, which means that one of those p orbitals is going to remain unhybridized. So I'll have 3 hybrid orbitals that are a combination. They're 1/3 s character and 2/3 p character each. They're about 2/3 of the way up energy-wise. And then 1 p orbital that remains unhybridized. So the electrons are going to redistribute so that I'll have a singly occupied sp2 orbital for each one. So there's 3 of those. And that allows for 3 sigma bonds to be made. And then there'll be 1 electron remaining in an unhybridized p orbital, and that allows for a pi bond to be made. So if we look at the atomic orbitals of carbon, we only have 2 unpaired electrons, and it looks like there should be 2 bonds and then a lone pair of electrons. But we know from all the bonding patterns that carbon can make, from what we observe, that that's not the case. We see that carbon makes 4 bonds in a variety of different ways. Sometimes it has double bonds, and that's where the pi bonding comes into play here. So to accommodate a carbon atom that would have a double bond or a pi bond and a sigma bond together, it's going to hybridize to make an sp2 hybrid carbon that allows for 3 sigma bonds and 1 pi bond to be made. And this is what's happening with respect to the linear combination of atomic orbitals to give these hybrid orbitals. So we'll go to the next slide and we'll take a look at what does that look like on an actual molecule. Okay, so if we draw an actual molecule here, I'm going to draw ethene. It's got a carbon-carbon double bond. And when I draw my Lewis structure, I really can't tell, you know, what type of bond it is. I just know that there are 2 bonds. There's 1 sigma bond here and 1 pi bond there. The Lewis structure, they look the same, right? This carbon atom here, either one of them, because they're the same, is sp2 hybridized. Remember our little trick. So we have s and p, and there's 2 p's. So all of these are 1/3 s character and 2/3 p character. So it's the combination of those. So if I put my superscripts on, 1 + 2 = 3. 3 is the number of things that'll be around that central atom that's hybridized. Things being either atoms that it's bonded to, or it could be a lone pair of electrons as well. And that's more common when we have a heteroatom as our central hybridized atom. But we've got 1 H here, another H that's 2, and then a carbon over here that's 3. There's 3 things around it. That's an sp2 hybridized carbon atom. The furthest apart 3 things can get is 120 degrees. So the bond angle of an sp2 hybridized carbon is 120 degrees, and the shape is trigonal planar. So those groups can all be in one plane when there are only 3 of them. I'm going to draw this another way so that we can see the bonding type better. So this thing is planar. Right now I've drawn it like putting my hand on the screen, okay? Now I'm going to draw it like tipping my hand out of the screen so it's coming in and out at you. So I'm going to draw my sigma bond as just a line like we do in Lewis structures. I'm going to use wedges and dashes to show this the kind of 3D nature of this as it sticks in and out of the plane so that you can see what's happening here. So it's still planar, but now it's just sort of perpendicular to the page instead of lying flat on the page. So remember, I use wedges to show that something is coming out at me, and then I can use a dash to show that something is going back. So I've drawn the sigma bond directly between the 2 nuclei. There is no more room for additional electrons there. And so the pi bond is going to be through p orbitals above and below the plane of the molecule. So that's why I've drawn it in 3D, so I can draw that and you can see it. So in organic chemistry, pi bonding is pretty much always between unhybridized p orbitals. And so those look like those peanuts. And so there's electron density that is overlapping above and below the two nuclei, the two central atoms there. And an orbital is really just a probability map of where electron density lies. We can think of this as roughly half of a pi bond below the plane of the molecule and the other half above the plane of the molecule. All right, so I'm going to draw this one more time so we can think about types of bonds again. So in the last video about sp3 hybridization, we talked about how terminal atoms don't tend to hybridize. So these H atoms are going to have 1s orbitals that are overlapping with whatever the hybridization of the central carbon atom is. In this case, both of these carbon atoms are going to be sp2 hybridized. They both have 3 atoms bonded to them, a total of 4 bonds, of course, but 3 atoms bonded to them. So they're sp2 hybridized. So if we think about, you know, the type of bond for, like, let's say that carbon atom, it has 2 times a sigma bond between that carbon, which is sp2 hybridized, and an H, which is able to bond with its 1s orbital there. So that would be this H and this H. And then it would have another sigma bond between it and the carbon next door to it. So that would be this carbon right here, right? So the carbon with the green arrow pointing to it is bonded to that carbon through a sigma bond that is just the overlap of 2 sp2 hybrid orbitals, and then also through a pi bond, right? So the pi bond is just going to be between 2 p orbitals. So we had said in the last slide that pi bonding in organic chemistry is between 2 p type orbitals. So there's an overlap of 2 electrons between an unhybridized p orbital on the carbon on the left and an unhybridized p orbital on the carbon on the right. So that carbon atom has 4 total bonds, 2 to H's, 1 to another carbon that's a sigma bond, and then another bond between those two carbons that is a pi bond, and those are between the 2 p orbitals. So this has been a look at sp2 hybridization in carbon atoms for organic chemistry. If you found this video helpful, please like, subscribe, and share with your friends. Thanks.